Hey guys, today I want to share with you some of my top time management tips as well as how to declutter your schedule. And in our busy lives, it is so easy for us to feel like we're drowning in a never-ending list of to-dos and an increasingly packed schedule. And it can be easy to wish that we had more hours in our day or even to spread ourselves too thin. But the secret to mastering time management isn't about finding the perfect organization or planning system, it's about simplifying. From routines to habits to relationships to social commitments, if an activity or a task isn't contributing to your overall well-being and the goals that you want to accomplish, it might need to go. So today we're going to talk about how to declutter your schedule and implement time management tips so that in doing less, you can actually do more. Before we dive in, I want to give a big thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. But let's get into this and let's start with my first tip, which is to perform a calendar audit. Have you ever said yes to something that didn't serve you, a task, an activity, whatever? My hand went up and I'm guessing yours did too. It can be really easy for us to overcommit and have a tendency to say yes to everything without necessarily thinking through, oh wait, does this contribute to my values, my goals, and what I want to be doing with my life? And an easy way to identify and eliminate those activities that don't serve you is to perform a calendar audit. Look at your calendar, look at your schedule for the past month and looking ahead for the next month and ask yourself, do the activities and the things on my schedule actually serve me? Are you attending networking events that you don't really enjoy? Are you taking a workout class that you don't get value from? Are you taking on too many responsibilities at work or at home? The quickest and easiest way to get back literally hours of your time each week is to simply take things off of your schedule. So perform a calendar audit, figure out what activities you're doing on a weekly or monthly basis that aren't serving you, and then eliminate them. My next step really ties into the last one, and it's to master the art of saying no. And we live in a culture that glorifies people saying yes and always taking on more responsibility. They're seen as team players when in reality, they're just people pleasers who will do anything to get the approval of those around them. And let's be clear, this is something that I've done and been guilty of myself. It's intimidating sometimes to say no, but in order to truly focus on our priorities and keep them front and center, we need to learn to master the art of saying no so that we can create space to focus on the things that are important to us. And that's the beauty of saying no to activities and tasks that don't serve us. Not only does saying no help us to win back time, it helps us to win back focus. And when we're able to get into that zone of focus and flow, we're able to be so much more productive and get a lot more accomplished in the time that we have. We're able to be more effective as well as to reach our goals faster. I've been taking this course on Skillshare on simple productivity, and one of the quotes in it that I've absolutely loved and been challenged by is that we're supposed to become the master of the quick no and the slow yes. Saying no isn't about being harsh or mean or selfish. It's about knowing what your priorities are and living in alignment with those and choosing only to say yes to opportunities that are in alignment as well. Now, this next tip might sound counterintuitive to some, but it is to get more sleep. And I have a question for you. How much sleep are you getting each night? I would venture to guess, if you're like most people, the answer is not enough. Sleep does so much more than just affect our mood for the following day. It affects how creatively we're able to think, how fast we're able to get things done, the amount of problem solving we're able to do. And study after study has really shown the importance of sleep in being able to perform work at a high level. We function at our best when we're getting around 8 hours of sleep per night. And it can definitely be tempting sometimes for us to feel like if we burn the candle at both ends, if we stay up late at night and get up early in the morning, that we'll be able to get more done because we're, technically speaking, staying up longer and adding more hours to our day. But unfortunately, when we're sleeping as little as possible and trying to squeeze extra hours into our day, what ends up happening is that we're less productive overall because our brains need that sleep to be able to function properly. Just getting an hour's extra sleep at night can make you more effective and productive throughout your workday. So if you want to really steward the time that you have each day well, a really powerful tool to be able to get more done in less time is to sleep more so that you can bring your A game to your work and to your life. And this next tip really has to do with focus and organization, and it is to write things down. Have you ever struggled to focus at work because your mind kept jumping around and thinking about all of the things that you had to complete throughout the day? Or maybe you had a hard time sleeping because your mind simply couldn't quiet down. You're definitely not alone if you felt that way. When we feel like we have tasks that we need to remember, it can be difficult for us to focus on anything else. Our minds keep coming back to that thing, trying not to forget it, but in the process, we end up losing our focus and our state of flow on whatever we were trying to accomplish in that moment. So in order to move on and get that reminder or that task out of your brain, it's important to write it down. And this is something that's going to help you literally gain back hours of your life, whether that's of sleep or of productive work. But I want you to write down those ideas or those thoughts and transfer them onto a piece of paper or a notes app on your phone. I'm not entirely sure where it's from, but I love the quote, "Your brain is for having ideas, not for holding them." And it is so true that when we're trying to hold onto ideas and to remember different thoughts, we have a hard time maintaining a deep level of concentration. But when we transfer those ideas and those thoughts onto paper, our minds immediately feel this sense of relief and this renewed ability to focus on whatever the task is at hand. So one really powerful way that I've been able to implement this is before I go to sleep at night, I outline everything that I want to accomplish for the next day. So I know it's written down and I can come back to it tomorrow, but I don't need to dwell on it when I'm trying to sleep at night. So put those ideas down onto paper and enjoy the focus and productivity that results. Okay, this is a huge one, and it's to set goals and work backwards. And so often in life, we have these large dreams and goals and things that we want to accomplish, but sometimes they can seem so insurmountable that we never really get to achieving them. And I'm a huge believer in pursuing those goals and chasing after those dreams, but in order to do that, we need to break those dreams and break those goals down into smaller, more tangible objectives. So take a few moments and think about where you want to be in a year, in 5 years. Where do you want to be? Who do you want to become? And what steps are involved in achieving that? The steps that you're taking today are either moving you towards your goals or away from your goals. And so I want you to take a step back and to think through, what do you want to achieve and how do you want to get there? Do you want to be a photographer? That's awesome. What steps do you need to take to move in that direction? What opportunities and experiences should you be saying yes to move you in that direction? What should you be saying no to? When you know what you want out of life and you identify your goals and your priorities, it becomes so much easier to distinguish the essential from the non-essential. So going through this exercise of setting goals and working backwards and identifying what steps you need to take to reach your goal can be a really helpful way of figuring out what's important to be on your schedule and what might be non-essential. And then my final tip is to learn more. Think back for a second about those goals and those dreams that you wrote down. My guess is that you have some incredible dreams and some incredible goals, but my question for you is, do you know how to get there? Whether you want to pick up a new hobby or start a business, you're going to be able to reach your goal 100 times faster if you know what to do and how to do it. And the best way to do that is to learn from somebody who's already accomplished what you're trying to do. Whether that means finding a coach, taking a class, or reading a book, learning more about the goal that you're trying to reach is going to help you not only to be more productive and focused so that you know what to do and how to do it, but it's also going to save you a lot of time and costly mistakes. So learning more about those goals that you want to reach is an extremely powerful way of being able to save time. And one resource I love for being able to learn more about the topics I'm interested in and the goals I want to reach is Skillshare. And Skillshare is an online community for the creative and curious that offers literally thousands of incredible classes on topics ranging from photography to art, to business, to marketing, to productivity, and so much more. And I love that their classes are designed for real life, so you can pursue your dreams without having to feel like you have to put your life on hold. And I've taken some great classes on Skillshare that have helped me to pursue things that I'm passionate about, like creating high quality YouTube videos, but one that I've been going through lately that I've absolutely been loving is the course Simple Productivity. It's taught by Greg McKeown, I'm not entirely sure how you say his name, but it's the author of the book Essentialism. And this course has so many incredible insights on how to simplify and create focus by saying no to the non-essential so that you can say yes to what's truly important. So absolutely, there are some amazing classes on Skillshare, but another one of my favorite things about the platform is that it's really affordable. You don't need to be paying hundreds of dollars for an in-person workshop or course. A Skillshare annual subscription lasts less than $10 a month. It's a great deal. Plus, if you're one of the first 500 people to sign up for Skillshare using the link in my description box, you can get your first 2 months of Skillshare for free. So if you are a creative and wanting to learn more, Skillshare is a fantastic resource for you. Check out that link in the description box. But absolutely, learning more about a topic or goal that you're interested in is going to help you hugely be able to accelerate the amount of time it takes for you to accomplish that goal. So those are some of my best tips on how to be a better steward of your time and how to declutter your schedule. Remember that this isn't so much about organization, but about prioritization. We want to say no to the non-essential, to the things that don't actually contribute to our overall well-being and to our overall goals, so we can say yes to the things that do. So let me know in the comments, what was your favorite time management tip that I shared? Or maybe is there one that you live by that I didn't mention here? Let me know that in the comments below, and thank you again to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Be sure to check them out. I'll have all of the information linked up in the description box below. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram. I'm at ashlyn.eaton on there for more simple and intentional living inspiration. That's it for this video though. Thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing. I love you guys all so much, and I will see you in the next one.